Hi, I'm John Underwood for Los Al TV. You know, the city of Los Alamitos has long considered itself a military town, our Joint Forces Training Base, which comprises about half of our landmass, has conducted over the years many moving and patriotic events honoring our military. But today and in recent years, an event for Memorial Day has gained participation and traction here in Los Alamitos, here just off Catella Avenue at the campus of Cottonwood Christian Center. They honor Memorial Day here in a very special way. The Memorial Day celebration at Cottonwood Christian Center, now in its fifth year, did include the customary Memorial Day parade, complete with banners, a marching color guard of retired veterans, a classic car and motorcycle drive-by. A complement of dignitaries to present awards and citations, and even a contingent of white doves released in honor of the dead who gave their all for this nation over the years. Many veterans groups and support organizations were also here on this day, proudly flying their colors and representing for their services.
Talk to anybody that's had a successful back surgery.
And to swap stories, of course, with their fellow vets. But all fell silent when an always moving flag folding ceremony conducted by these 82nd Airborne veterans took center stage.
The second fold we make in honor and remembrance of the comrades who gave their lives for the defense of our country and this flag, to show that their efforts to attain peace throughout the world have not been in vain and shall never be forgotten. We next fold to the left in the shape of a triangle, for this is where our hearts lie. As it is with our hearts, we pledge allegiance to the flag. We fold again to the left in the shape of a triangle, representing our weaker nature. But we as American citizens trust in God, and it is to Him we turn in times of peace, as well as in times of war, for His divine guidance. We fold to the right as a tribute to our armed forces. For it is through these same armed forces that we protect our country and our flag from all her enemies, whether they are found within or without the boundaries of our republic. We fold again to the right as a tribute to our country. From the words of Stephen Decatur, our country, in dealing with other countries, may she always be right, but is still our country, right or wrong. We fold to the left as a tribute to our mothers, for whom it flies on Mother's Day. God of the ones who entered into the valley of the shadow of death, so that we might see the light of day. We fold again to the left as a tribute to womanhood, for it's been through their faith, love, loyalty, and devotion that the characters of the men that have made this country great have been molded. We fold to the right as a tribute to our fathers, for they also have given their sons and daughters for the defense of our country since she was born. We fold from the stripes to the stars. While the stripes represent the 13 original colonies that founded our republic, they are embodied in the 50 sovereign states represented by the stars, that the stars cover the stripes. We fold to the left in the shape of a triangle. For the eyes of a Hebrew citizen, this represents the lower portion of the seal of King David and King Solomon, and glorifies in their eyes the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. We fold again to the left in the shape of a triangle. For in the eyes of a Christian citizen, this represents an emblem of eternity and glorifies in their eyes God the Father, God the Son, and God the Holy Spirit. When our flag is completely folded, only the stars are visible, which reminds us of the national motto, In God We Trust. It has 13 folds, representing the 13 original colonies, and forms a triangle, symbolic of the three branches of government, judicial, executive, and legislative. After the flag is completely folded and tucked in, it takes on the appearance of a three-cornered cocked hat, ever reminding us of the soldiers who served under General George Washington, the sailors and Marines who served under Captain John Paul Jones, and followed by their comrades in the armed forces of the United States, who have preserved for us the rights, privileges, and freedom which we are enjoying today. This, ladies and gentlemen, is the American flag.
Thank you so much. Thank you. And are you going to release a dove?
Chaplain Doreen Matsumoto at Cottonwood, who runs the local chapter of the American Veterans Assistance Group, was the organizer and shot caller for this event on the campus of Cottonwood Church. And she explains the day's event and its primary focus.
Okay. Chaplain Doreen Matsumoto.
Yes.
Are you a chaplain here at Cottonwood?
I do the veterans outreach, and yes, I volunteer here at Cottonwood, but my normal job is for American Veterans Assistance Group, and I'm a full-time chaplain there.
Okay, and you are the full-time point person here today.
That is true. That is true.
I'm sorry to take just a few moments and ask you, give us a little perhaps framing for today's event, what's going to take place, and why?
Well, this is for Memorial Day. It is to honor and remember our veterans, our female veterans and our male veterans. We just love them. And the people that went to war and fought for our country, you know, we are the land of the free because of those brave. And when we started the Veterans Outreach back in 2017 here at Cottonwood, we do three events yearly. One is a Veterans Day luncheon. We do a recognition night where we give out awards and gifts and quilts of valor from SoCal Quilts of Valor. And then we do our Memorial Day event, which is a luncheon, but we started off with a really amazing parade. We recruit classic cars, motorcycles. We have 82nd Airborne out of the American Legion Post 295, and they'll be coming down. We have a special guest, veteran Howard Koch, World War II. So you'll probably catch him in a little bit. Since 2017, we've been doing three events a year. American Veterans Assistance Group partners with Cottonwood Church to do these events here. And as long as they want them, I will be here to help.
Okay, well, I'm going to let you get back to making it happen.
Yes.
And thank you for giving us some framing on today's event.
Yes, thank you for being here, and we appreciate the City of Los Al.
Thank you.
Hi, you're waving, yeah.
The heart of this particular Memorial Day event lies in its recognition of individual veterans whose stories stand out as living examples of the reason we pause on this day to honor those living and dead who stood in harm's way for their country. Several of those honored vets were in attendance on this day. One of those honored was Howard Koch, Army veteran who served in two of America's greatest conflicts, World War II and Korea. Shown here outside Cottonwood Hall, receiving the ceremonial folded flag. A little later, Howard enjoys a pleasant moment with the ladies. He doesn't seem to mind the attention.
I'm moving to Texas, and my wife says she's going to get me a trike.
Howard Koch, we've done this every year Carmen Erickson is here. She received the flag. And the reason we do that is because I've done services at the National Cemetery, and it's so heartwarming to pass this flag to someone. But why didn't we give it to them when they were alive? And so that's why we do it, because we want you to know. So every year we pick someone different and let them know how special they are. But most of all, you are all special. And we just thank you so much. Give yourselves a round of applause.
Inside at the luncheon, honoring Howard and others cited on this day, Howard, now 96, talks about his military experiences attached to the famed 10th Mountain Division in Italy in World War II, and what he has learned from all of his military experiences, and what he remembers most of all after all these years.
Okay, just a word with Howard Koch.
Yes.
Yes, I got that right.
Good, fine.
Okay.
Yeah.
And Howard, you're being recognized today.
Yes, today.
As an outstanding individual, someone who has served his country many times over.
Twice.
Yeah.
I served twice in the Army.
World War II and Korea.
Yes.
Yeah. I see on your patch there, on your lapel, it indicates the 10th Mountain Division.
10th Mountain Division.
And you were with the 10th Mountain Division, apparently in Italy?
Italy. Yes, we had the opportunity to escort the Germans out of Italy. And it was not quite as pleasant as they might have wanted, but we escorted the Germans out of Italy, back into Austria and Germany, from January 1945 to May 2nd of 1945, when they decided they'd had enough, and they surrendered to the 10th Mountain Division General George P. Hayes, who was our general, a wonderful guy who figured out a lot of our movements and the movements we were able to make in northern Italy to drive the Germans out.
And you saw, apparently, you saw
a lot of
combat.
Action.
Yeah.
Yeah, we had
a picture with Jack?
Our first warfare, we had to climb a 2,500 foot cliff, and we climbed it with ropes, and we got to the top and found no Germans there immediately. So we dug in on the top of the mountain, and then we went out after we were prepared, and we went out and found all the Germans, about 60 or 70 of them, in a dugout where they were sleeping. So we got to ask them to kommen Sie heraus mit der Hände herauf, which means come out with your hands up. And they did that, and they were rather surprised, but they did have a good night's sleep, which was fortunate for us because we made a lot of noise coming up that cliff. And when we were climbing up that cliff, and we were concerned that they might hear us, but they were sleeping.
So is that why we won the war? Because we get up earlier or got up early?
Got up early. And then, of course, then the Germans found out we were up there, and they sent more and more troops up to drive us off the top. But we kept, the sergeants taught us how to shoot first. And that's what we did. We shot first, and we won that battle. Then we had several other battles as we drove the Germans northward out of the country of Italy.
So But your service extends even further than World War II. You actually served in Korea.
The Korean War.
So how do you feel about being singled out, really, today, among a lot of veterans here today? You're 97?
96.
96 years old?
I'll be 97 pretty soon.
Okay.
If I keep going, yeah.
I have a feeling you will, just judging from the look as you were surrounded outside by those young girls.
That helps me. Yeah, it helps me stay. That helped me.
And they were pretty impressed with you, too.
Oh, well, yeah, I was more impressed with them.
It must be that Spencer Tracy face.
Thank you for calling me Spencer Tracy. He was one of my heroes in the movie.
Yeah. Well, how do you feel about being singled out today? Your specific longevity in the military. How do you feel about being honored today?
I just thank God for my beautiful life. I've had a wonderful life. A beautiful life. I can't think, except I didn't like the war. I didn't like to kill anybody, but I did. I had to. Otherwise, the other guys would kill me. That was the way it is in the war. And so, when you learn that, and I had a lot of good teachers in the Army, it was... I really think my Army service was very important to me in my future life, because the Army was, of course, on occasion I might not have liked it, but it was just excellent training to learn how to take orders and to learn how to fight wars, really, to learn how to maneuver, and we, of course, we were in the ski troops, and we had to ski up in Colorado. That was, we just, all our maneuvers were on skis, and we climbed the mountain with the skis, and then sometimes we could ski down, but not much skiing down. We just had to climb up and ski, and it was a really good training. Except for that night I had to spend out once in 40 below zero. And that was not as pleasant as I would have liked, but we were out for 6 weeks. Never went back to the barracks. Just stayed out in the beautiful Rocky Mountains and survived. It was just learning how to survive.
Well, it sounds like a charmed life. Except for the parts where they were shooting at you, I guess.
Oh yeah, when they, that's the game, see. They shot at us, we shot at them, and on occasion, I can remember one occasion when our artillery was so good that they destroyed some of the German soldiers, and one of them was lying out there. And when we got up to the top of the mountain, I took a blanket over and covered him over because he was very much destroyed by the artillery. So you have feelings for human beings. One has to have feelings of taking care of fellow human beings. And this is what I was trained to do.
If I might hazard a question this intimate, what would you say was the most important thing you learned from your service that you could pass on to younger veterans still struggling with their tours of duty, with PTSD, various different kinds of ailments that they had, that they acquired while in service, in theater, in action? What word of encouragement or of honest wisdom would you give them?
Uh, trust in your buddies, your fellow soldiers. They'll help you in all times. You can trust in your own fellow soldiers in the Army. I found that was one of the biggest things I had the opportunity as a platoon leader of 36 men in combat. And I, at one time, had to take these men out on patrols, combat patrols. And I want to tell you, they were wonderful guys. All of them, every one of them was a wonderful man. I never had anybody that failed me.
Think sometimes of the ones who didn't come back?
Oh, all the time.
Do they stick in your head
all
still?
All the time. Yeah, that's the bad part. Some dumb didn't get to come back. Didn't get to live life that I did. You know, my life been just outstanding. Blessing. It's just been a blessing because everything I did after the comeback from the war was, and then I had a career in the United States in the sales business, where I enjoyed, with my accounting experience, enjoyed helping businesses all around in various areas, but primarily in California initially. Again, these are all wonderful gentlemen that I work with. We've just had wonderful times together, and that all starts maybe learning something in the Army. And I had so many good friends in the Army. So
not much difference between the veterans of today and the
I don't think so. I think they're all good. Huh? Look at this young guy. You could have a better guy, could you? Huh? You could have a better guy in your outfit than that man. And he's a Marine. Well, and this one here.
What's the matter with that guy?
I knew his parents too, see? So that's pretty good. He loved those parents, and so did I.
they're certainly younger than you, but just between you and me, they're not better looking.
Well, I think I hope I impressed those girls. Oh, thank you, dear. Thank you.
You came all the way from the Harbor Beach.
Hi.
Hi. Say thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. And I thank you for these lovely children.
You want to keep them?
Huh? You're the mommy?
Yeah. Oh, I'm Crystal. I'm Doreen's daughter.
Doreen's daughter.
Yeah.
Oh. what's your name?
Crystal.
Crystal, yeah.
Crystal,
yeah. That's Crystal, your mommy. Yeah, what a wonderful. What a wonderful.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, Crystal.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you, dear.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Thank you, son. Thank you, lucky daughter.
Thank you very much.
And thank you,
Howard. Mr. Underwood, thank you. Yeah.
And after all these years, and with every new generation, we say thanks on this day to Howard Koch and all who have served. For Los Al TV, I'm John Underwood.